fourth quarter once again is when the Nets offense comes alive. Sarah, there were points during this game where you thought, all right, they're just going to take over. At some point, everything is going to start clicking. It took a while, but in that fourth quarter, they found that rhythm, and James Harden, while he was unselfish throughout most of the first three quarters, he took over when he had to.
It's the time to be special, and that's what we've seen out of these players. The other night it was Kyrie Irving. This night it was James Harden, yeah, along with the others, everyone playing their part. And I think this is going to be an important game just in terms of the growth and learning experience for everyone, because it's a night they struggled yeah, mightily from the field, and we hadn't necessarily seen that out of Kevin Durant or out of a variety of players. To think about the fact that they shot 29% from the three-point line, 40% from the field, yeah, but still were doing the things and pushing the buttons that they needed to win. And when it was closing time, they made the plays they needed to, and it wasn't just about the offensive side of the ball and making some shots, but I was really impressed too with what they did defensively, how they rotated, how they communicated, yep, how they moved. And I think for those reasons, there is a lot of good to be taken out of this.
How about the rotation itself from Steve Nash, mixing and matching lineups and couple of new looks in there in the second half?
How important, because these are the things that you start to get more comfortable with when you have a better feel for guys. And I think in some ways it's experimentation of, yep, what different combinations look like. We saw different lineups and different players on the floor with one another as you start to see who works well within the course of those lineups. But two, when you came down to the end of the game, you had some fresh legs for Kevin Durant, yeah, some fresh legs for James Harden, Joe Harris as well, James Harden. So I think for a variety of different areas to look at, this is a good opportunity to see how you're going to work in that rotation and start to get a level of consistency, because that's going to be important as everyone continues to learn their roles.
How about the look ahead now? The Atlanta Hawks, a team that the Nets saw in one of these two-game series earlier this season. They split with Atlanta. Things have leveled off a bit for the Hawks after the hot start. Still a very talented group, and certainly gave the Nets everything that they could handle that was pre-James Harden.
Yeah, and the start of a road trip for the Nets, so that's another aspect to look at. But despite the way that Atlanta has been playing, we know they have very capable players, yep, on the offensive end, the type of threats that Trae Young and John Collins bring to the table, along with many of those young players who are still looking at a level of inconsistency, yep, so they are going to bring their best. And I think that circles back to the fact for the Nets, as they've learned, no matter who they're playing, no matter what the opponent, no matter how that team may be playing at a certain time, when Brooklyn Nets come to town, they are going to get their best shot, their best effort. And so a good chance for the Nets now, having won these last two games, how do you keep building on that and building on the comfort level with one another that we've started to see?
So the Nets get it done against a shorthanded Miami team. Now it's on the road for three straight away from Brooklyn.